So to my family and friends out there, I thought I would give you a little bit of information that might be helpful to you. I know pretty much everybody out there has been hunting for hand sanitizers and different things that they can disinfect with. Working in food service and some medical areas all my life, I've learned a few little tricks that they use in these professions to, you know, sanitize surfaces and themselves and such things. I have personally went out and I purchased the items to make my own hand sanitizer. It's pretty simple, pretty simple. I went to buy hand sanitizer at our local DG and Family Dollar and some of the other stores, and there just wasn't any available. So I figured I would give you guys a little heads up on how to make your own hand sanitizer. So basically what you need is you need to go out and get yourself some type of an aloe vera gel or some type of a basic gel that you can get. What I did is I got some cheap stuff from the dollar store. Thought I would show you this. Going to be printed backwards, I think. If not, you'll be able to see it. This is a tropical gel that's just an aloe vera gel, 100%, you know, nothing much to it. So I took this stuff and I put it in a mixing apparatus, and I also then went out and got myself some 91% pure isopropyl alcohol. Now I think you can get 99%, but I'm not sure of that, but this will work just fine. What I did is I took and I measured it out and I did a 10-to-1 ratio with alcohol, with the gel and the alcohol, which is pretty strong. Actually, it doesn't need to be that strong, but you know, I like it a little strong. I like to be able to smell the alcohol when I'm putting this stuff on. I mixed it all up and I put it back in its appropriate bottles, and it seems to work out just great. You know, a lot of people are wondering, well, what kind of, you know, I just took some basic push bottles from like hand lotion or whatever. This is the one that I use for my big bottle for filling up my smaller, you know, pocket-sized bottles and ones that I leave sitting around the house for the sinks and such things. And I mixed it up and put it in those larger bottles. You can do yourself, save yourself some money, for one. I think that aloe vera gel was $1 a bottle at the dollar store or one of our, you know, small, you know, cheap stores around here, and the alcohol I think was $2. So you're talking about $3 to make enough hand sanitizer to last you for a whole year. I mean, I got a ton of it. It's unbelievable. I got 2 bottles of the gel and a bottle of the alcohol. I used probably a third of the bottle of alcohol and the 2 bottles of gel. And dude, I'm gonna have hand sanitizer until the day I die. But it's very helpful, and you know, just to throw out there, if you guys want to do that kind of thing, it's real easy. The other thing is for spraying surfaces, all I do, got a spray bottle from whatever type of spray, a Windex bottle, whatever the case may be, anything that will atomize the liquid that you're spraying on. I used a cup of bleach, you know, regular standard household bleach. Half a cup of any type of laundry soap, and the only reason I use a laundry soap is because, you know, you can use dish soap too, an antibacterial dish soap or whatever you want, and you mix that up and put it into some type of a spray bottle and keep it mixed and use that for spraying your surfaces. It's simple, guys. I mean, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure this stuff out. You don't need to go out and pay $4 for a antibacterial spray, because it's got exactly the same ingredients in it that you would make if you were at home. Like I said, just a Windex bottle, some bleach, a little bit of, you know, depending on the volume that you're making, a little bit of dish soap or laundry soap, and mix it up with water, cold water preferably. You know, try not to make the soap foam, of course. You can use an HG soap if you want, you know, for your front load washers or whatever. Worked out great, you know. I haven't been sick so far, so it must be working out. You know, like the man said on TV, you know, wash your hands repeatedly throughout the day, you know, keep your face washed twice a day at least. You know, so if you go out, wash your face, wash your hands. You know, when you come back, I've been spraying surfaces of everything that I buy, such as, you know, if I go out and buy cans of coffee, I'll disinfect the cans of coffee, canned goods, anything like that. Anything that I can spray and disinfect when I bring it home, I do. Just, you know, it's just smart science, you know. If you bring something into your environment, you know, you need to sanitize it before it can infect your environment. You know, you get a can of coffee at the DG, 150 people have touched that can of coffee throughout its delivery system. And on the shelf, you know, 18 old ladies picked it up to read what the ingredients in whatever it is are and whether they wanted to buy it and then put it back on the shelf. Well, disinfect it before once you bring it into your home. You know, it's just smart. It's just smart, you know. And you can spray it with that solution that you made with the bleach and the water and the dish soap. So just a few tips out there for anybody who needs it. You can make this stuff dirt cheap. You don't have to go out and go crazy buying 900 bottles of sanitizer and buying out the store, you know, just because you're spooked about this virus. You can make a lot of this stuff at home on your own. You can also find recipes online if you'd like to do it that way and not listen to me because you think I don't know what I'm talking about. All right, folks. I love y'all, family, friends. Be safe. Stay in your houses the way you're supposed to. Keep your contact down as minimal as possible. We love you. You know, myself and my wife love y'all. Family and friends, you know, be safe, and we'll see you on the other side. Later.